All right, please forgive the state of my eyebrows. I have to go get them threaded and I haven't done that yet, so they look a mess. So the first thing that we're going to do, as always, is going to prime our eyelids, and I'm going to be using Urban Decay Primer Potion in the original one. I still have these tiny little ones that I bought from Ulta. Like, it came in a pack of four and it had all the primer potions, the different kinds, and I'm going through them as quickly as I can because they are kind of small. Even though they do last a long time, I do my makeup all the time. So the first thing, like I said, we're going to do is going to take that little brush, and place it all over our lids. Then we're going to take the Sephora Jumbo Eyeliner Pencil that I have, Jumbo Pencil in white. And we're going to place that just in the lid area. Then I'm going to take my Urban Decay shadow brush, and it's this one, the synthetic flat brush that looks sort of like a foundation brush for your eyes, basically. That's how I say it. And I'm going to just spread that out, make sure it's all even so that one side isn't more intense than the other. Next, we're going to take our blue Had Me at Hello, and we are going to take this eyelid color right here. I'm just going to use one of my regular Sephora brushes, all over eyeshadow brush 22. It's just a flat little regular brush. And we're going to place that so that it's really intense in the first half of the eye. First half of the lid, sorry. I'm still not very good at this tutorial stuff. Then I'm going to take a fluffy brush, and this is my MAC 224. And I got these like many, many, many years ago. They're like, this is like the tiny little travel size one. And I'm just going to take it and just blend out the lid area so you won't get like a really harsh line in the crease area. That's all I wanted to do with that clean blending brush. Next, we're going to take our Vanity palette, and we're going to take the medium tone matte brown right here. It's next to the gold. I'm going to use that brush that I just showed you, the MAC 224. Whatever. And I'm gonna take that and knock some off, and then I'm going to put that in the crease and fade up to the brow bone. I want it right below that brow bone. Like, I don't want it to go above where I would put my highlighter, but this is just gonna create a nice gradient effect and make everything kind of go together instead of having harsh lines everywhere. Next, we're gonna go on to the Vanity palette one more time, and we're going to go to this shimmery side right here, and we're gonna go to the darkest shimmery shade that we have. Take that brush, tap off the excess, and we're gonna go to the outer V and up into the crease and a little towards where the teal is. We're going to take that Sigma brush one more time, and we're going to go to the darkest matte shade in the Vanity palette, this one right here, and tap some of the excess off. And then we're going to do just in the corner, in the outer corner, and a little into the crease, but not as far in as we did with the shimmery darkest shade. And we're gonna go a little up, maybe do a little bit higher of a V right there. At least I like to do it that way. You don't have to. I'm going to take a clean blending brush one more time and blend all of this out. Finally, for the outer V area, the final step would be going back to that Blue Had Me at Hello palette and going to the darkest matte black that they have here. The darkest, of course, is the darkest. It's black. Oh boy. Tap some of that off, and I'm actually going to use my e.l.f. crease brush? My e.l.f. Professional crease brush. And I'm gonna take that, knock some off, and just do that little outer V right there, just to get some definition, little high. That's all we want, just a little bit of definition there. Sometimes the browns mixed all together just looks like a muddy mess. So I'm gonna take my Eco Tools fluffy brush, which is my favorite brush to use as with my highlighter, my Brulee from Wet n Wild highlighter. Just gonna put that right there and blend down a little bit so we can fade out some of that darkness. Can look rather harsh, almost raccoon eyes. Now I'm gonna use my angled brush, my angled eyeliner brush that I always like to use for my eyeliner, and I'm going to go with my MAC Blitz and Glitz. I absolutely love these Fluidline eyeliner, gel eyeliners, because I feel like they have such a great payoff and for very little amount. Like, I don't have to use a lot to get that intense black that I want. So I'm going to go in and line my top line, make it as thin as possible. And I'm also gonna take whatever's left on my eyeliner, I'm going to take it and put it in the bottom lash line. I'm going to take my mascara, Maybelline 1x1 Volume Express Mascara. I'm just going to use it on my top lashes. My small angle brush from Sigma. And I'm actually going to spray some of my e.l.f. I'm going to spray some of my e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Set onto that brush. And I'm also going to go back in to the eyelid color on Blue Had Me at Hello, the one that we put all over our lids. And I'm going to go underneath my lash line right here. I'm going to go halfway through. Wipe that brush off, and I'm going to go in with my darkest shimmering shade in the Vanity palette. I'm going to wet the brush, and I'm just going to go to the other half with this. Then I'm going to take my NYX Jet Black slide-on eyeliner, and I'm going to do that. Apply this on my waterline. And that is it for my the eye portion. And now I'm going to go into my face and tell you what I put on. So this is the final look, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. For my face, I actually had to go back to my Laura Mercier tinted moisturizer in caramel. This is what it looks like. I did a half marathon on April 28th, and it was really sunny, and even though I brought sunblock with me, I completely forgot to use it before I started the race, and I got a little darker a little sooner than I had hoped that I'd get darker, just so I can finish up some of my lighter makeup, I guess is the best way. But that's fine, because I get to finish off my Laura Mercier tinted moisturizer, which I do love, but I love my Smashbox sheer tinted moisturizer a lot better. So yes, I went to this one, and I didn't use any concealer today. I didn't feel like my eyes were that bad, even though I think since I had a smoky look, I should have done it anyways. But whatever, I didn't do it. On my cheeks, for contouring, I actually used my Chocolate Soleil bronzer, and this is from my Too Faced Sweet Dreams palette. It was handy right there, and I didn't want to use my e.l.f. one, which is the one I've been using lately, because e.l.f. has a little bit of shimmer in it, and since I felt that this eye look was very shimmery, very bold, I didn't want more shimmer all over my face. So I just used my Chocolate Soleil for that. And I also used my Tarte Amused blush, my 12-hour long blush. And this is in Amused. Oh, I did use a little bit of a highlighter on my face. I used my Mary-Lou Manizer highlighter. And I used it with this fan brush that I got. Oh God, I don't even know where I got this. It's like El Cheapo fan brush here. And I just used a little bit on my, with my luminizer, just that tap and all over my face wherever I wanted a little bit of a highlight. And for my lips, I have a Revlon Color Burst Lip Butter in Berry Smoothie. I'm sure everybody has seen the Revlon lip butters by now. You guys are all sick of them, I'm sure. And on top of my Revlon lip butter, I wanted something a little bit more pinker and shiny, I guess. And I'm using my NYX Mega Gloss, Mega Shine Lip Gloss. My NYX Mega Shine Lip Gloss, and this one is in Ice Princess. So that's it for my tutorial on this look, inspired and I guess copied by this look on Pinterest that I saw, and I said, oh my God, I can so do this look. And this look is all brought to you by Wet n Wild Blue Had Me at Hello. The only reason I repurchased this is because Nessa Irene 0206, she did an amazing collection of videos with all three of the Wet n Wild 8 palette icon color thing. Anyways, she did amazing tutorials with these. I had this at one time. When they first came out, I bought all three, and I was so intimidated by these colors. Like, I do not normally wear blue eyeshadow at all. I'm very intimidated by blue, even though I think it's beautiful. My skin color, especially my skin tone, since I have a yellow under skin tone color. Oh, I can't speak today. But since normally it doesn't blend very well with me, I look better in greens and purples and warmer tones, and blues are definitely cooler look. I normally don't gravitate towards those. And she did such an amazing job and totally got me like, oh my God, I have to get this palette again. I have to try this out, because she did such great looks with them. Even just using the basic combos here or mix and matching, she just did a great job. I'm going to link her down below so you guys can check her out, check out her videos. I think they're great. I think she's so great, really funny girl. So I think that's it for me. Thank you everybody so much for watching. As always, I got a haircut recently. Oh, that's what I wanted to say. I got a haircut and I'm not sure how I'm liking it, but it's there, so I can't do anything about it. It's gone. So I'm trying to grow my hair out, but not as long as I had it, because I actually had it almost to my butt. And then I cut it really short and donated it to Locks of Love, and I have been trying to grow it out ever since. And it's been a slow process, but I think it's gotten pretty long. Let me see. Yeah, it's gotten pretty long. It used to be all the way down to my butt, so I'm used to having longer hair. But I like the haircut, because I feel like my hair looks a little bit healthier. My ends always get really fry really quickly, and I like that I have a little bit of layers, even though I wanted the layers to be, I don't know. Anyways, enough about the hair. Thank you everybody so very much for watching. Please comment, subscribe, and like this video if you want to do all of the above. And it's not mandatory. You guys don't have to. I'm not forcing you to. But I really appreciate it when you guys do it. And I hope you guys have a great day. Bye.